Okay, I'm getting ready to do a mixed media piece, and what I'm using is the Strathmore Bristol paper that comes in the yellow pad. And I've taped off a size of about 8 by 10, so the inside will be around an 8 by 10, and then I'll be matting it to much larger. And I'm going to start out with fluid acrylics. And then I'm going to do some mark making, may add some pastel, may add some stencil work. I don't know yet. But I'm just going to play around and have some fun and see what happens. And the color that I'm putting on right now is phthalo turquoise. And I just used a drop of it. And it's I put a lot of water into it. So here we go. I want to get a drip right in there. There it goes. Hopefully. There we go. Now I'm going to put a touch of black into this. Just to make it a little bit darker. Okay, I ended up drying it with the hair dryer. So what I'm going to do now, I think I'm going to, this is the Art Crayon by Marabou. It's in white. It's actually showing up gray, but it is white. Didn't really show up at all, actually. Let's try something else. This is a Crink marker. Okay, now I'm going to let that dry. I think I'll dry it with the hair dryer. We'll put some white acrylic into it. Ooh, look what's happening. I definitely have to let this dry before I go any further. Not quite sure what I'm going to do yet. And that gives me a thinner line than this. This is a Chinese chopstick. Okay, I'm going to dry this. I'm happy with what's happening. Don't know, I don't have a clue where I'm going, but I like what's happening. As I was drying it, I was looking at it and thinking to myself, I'm going to do something down here. So I'm going to get a small brush. I can find one. Like a small round brush. Do a little bit of detail work. I'm just filling in some of those shapes. Don't like that one. the light better without that light on. Yeah, I think that's better. Wanted to break up this line here. Not happy with that. Not happy with that either. Wasn't happy with that at all. So now I'm going to let it dry. And then I'm going to go, don't like any of that either. I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to put some black on my palette. That way, I have a lot of different stuff going on. It is running a little bit, which I like. I can spray just a little bit, see what happens. don't want it to run down the middle. Okay, this is soaking wet, so I have to let this dry now. But I have said that before, haven't I? Okay, I'm going to turn you off for a little bit. Okay, I'm going to put some clear gesso on it now because I think I'm going to put pastel on it tomorrow. So I'm going to, what I'm using is Liquitex clear gesso. Here it is right here. Liquitex clear gesso. And it goes on cloudy, but it is clear. After it's dry, it will be clear. And I want to put lots on. And what this clear gesso will do, it'll give me a surface. That my pastel can hook onto. Going on cloudy, like I said, but it will be clear after it dries. So I had the entire thing covered. I want to just double check by looking at it sideways. Yep, I have it covered good. I want to have plenty on. Okay. So I will check back with you guys tomorrow.